Welcome to Cubitos. 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 I don't know, but you're cubes, you're racing, and you do that by rolling a bunch of dice. Each player chooses a color and takes the matching two runner cubes and player board, along with one phase token, seven light gray starting dice, and two dark gray starting dice. Place your phase token next to your player board with the green roll phase side face up. Put all nine of your starting dice in your player board's draw zone. Next, choose what set of ability cards you'll be playing with for this game from the list on page 8 of the rulebook. Choose a racetrack and place it in the center of the playing area, and have each player put one of their runner cubes on the start space. Put the fan track near the racetrack, and have each player put their other runner cube on the bleachers. Finish setting up the playing space by laying out the ability cards you've chosen around the racetrack like so, and setting up the matching colored dice boxes near each, placing all corresponding dice inside their respective boxes. Set up the four gray token boxes to create a supply for the draw and credit tokens, and form a pile of unused gray dice somewhere nearby. Randomly select the first player, put the start player die in their roll zone, the table space above your player board, and setup is complete. The game is played in a series of rounds. Each round consists of a roll phase and a run phase, and for the most part, everybody plays at the same time within each phase. First, move dice from your draw zone to your roll zone until the number of dice in your roll zone is equal to your draw amount. At the start of the game, everyone has a draw amount of 9. Note that the start player die does not count toward your draw amount. It's a bonus for that round's start player. If you have more dice in your draw zone than what's needed to reach your limit, which ones you draw are your choice. If you run out of dice in your draw zone before you've reached your limit, move all the dice from your discard zone to your draw zone and continue drawing. When you've finished drawing your dice, you'll roll all the dice in your roll zone. If any of your dice have something on the face you've rolled, move them to the active zone on your player board. Note that any time you roll anything other than a blank, that die must be moved to your active zone. Next, choose to either push or pass. If you push, roll the remaining dice again. Be careful though, because once you have 3 or more dice in your active zone, you bust if you roll all blanks, immediately moving all your active zone dice to the discard zone, along with as many dice from your roll zone as you choose. Then, you'll advance your fan track runner one space before flipping your phase token to the run phase. If you pass, leave all your dice where they are and flip your phase token. Most of the time, the roll phase is carried out simultaneously. Sometimes, though, you might see a strategic advantage in waiting to see what other players are doing. In these instances, the player with the most dice in their roll zone must act first, breaking ties for the most dice in clockwise order from the start player. Let's talk about what all the different symbols on your dice mean. Footprints are movement, used to move your runner along the racetrack. Coins are money, used for purchasing new dice, additional movement, and some other costs. Coins you don't spend are lost at the end of each round. Credits serve the same purpose as coins, but they can be saved to use during future rounds. Credits are square, coins are round. That's how you tell them apart. Ability symbols are used to trigger abilities on the corresponding ability card. Power symbols have these 4 little dots around the outside, which indicate another effect that's triggered alongside the ability as described on the card. Abilities, unless otherwise specified, are always optional to resolve. But if you choose to resolve the regular ability on a power symbol, you must also resolve the extra power. Aside from the gray starting dice and the start player die, all dice have a corresponding ability card. These cards show you how much each die of that type will cost, what each face of the die looks like, and what ability you'll be able to use whenever you roll the appropriate symbol. Now abilities are used immediately after you move a die with that symbol into your active zone. Active abilities are used based on the context of that ability, as long as the die is in your active zone. And run abilities can only be used during the run phase. Credit, coin, and movement symbols are also only used during the run phase, which begins once all players have finished the roll phase. Again, this phase can mostly be carried out simultaneously, but whenever that poses a problem, resolve each player's entire phase in clockwise order from the start player. First, players may use any run abilities they have. Then, when everyone's ready, compare the total number of sword icons in everyone's active zones and resolve the effect of the red card. This ability card is a little different than the others because it's only available to whoever has the most swords for that round. If the card says start player die breaks tie, ties are broken in clockwise order from the start player. If it doesn't indicate a tiebreaker, no one has the most swords this round. After swords are taken care of, players may continue using abilities and figuring out their total coins and movement for the round. For every footprint you have, you may move your runner one space on the racetrack. You may also buy additional footprints at a cost of 4 coins or credits each. Runners don't block the movement of other runners, simply stack them on top of each other if they happen to land on the same space. You don't have to use all your movement if you don't want to, but whatever you don't use is lost at the end of the round. If you land on a reward space and end your movement there, you gain that reward. Reward spaces with a credit symbol mean you'll gain that many credits. A flag indicates you gain a fan by advancing your runner on the fan track by one space and gaining what rewards the new space indicates. The lose a die space means you return one die of your choice to its tray. Gray starting dice can either go back to the box or to the supply pile on the table. The gain a die space means you claim one die of any color and put it in your discard pile. If there's a cost on the space, you pay that instead of the usual cost for the die. If there's no cost on the space, you gain the die for free. After you finish your move step, you may choose to spend coins and credits to buy new dice. You may buy up to 2 new dice each round, but they can't both be of the same color. This limit does not apply to dice you gain from reward spaces or any other dice you may acquire. Whenever you gain a new die, place it in your discard zone. Finish your run phase by moving all the dice in your active zone to your discard zone. Leave all the dice in your roll zone where they are. Then, flip your phase token to the roll side and wait until everyone else has finished their run phase. When they have, pass the start player die to the next player and start a new round. Your draw amount starts at 9 at the beginning of the game, but you'll increase it by 1 permanently every time you gain one of these purple hand tokens, generally from the fan track. You'll also temporarily increase your draw amount by 1 for every red line on the racetrack that separates your runner from the current leader. Some other stuff to keep in mind about the racetrack. You can't move into water unless you're using an ability that says otherwise. Note that the ability is required every time you move into water, even if you're moving from one water space to another. Shortcut spaces allow you to skip large portions of the board if you pay the cost indicated. Sometimes this will be paid in coins and credits, sometimes in movement. The jetpack doubles any movement you have left for this phase as soon as you cross it. When any runner crosses the finish space on the racetrack, the end of the game is triggered. Finish the current round and determine the winner based on who made it the furthest across the finish line. It's easiest to track this by moving your runner back to the start and continuing forward based on how much movement you have left. If, after triggering the end of the game, 2 or more players have tied for the furthest distance past the finish line, all players continue playing until one clear winner emerges. And that's the gist of how to play Cubitos. Or however you say it.
Hey there, my name's Kyle McCarlin. I'm a voice actor by trade. You may have heard me as one of these guys. But I'm here to talk to you now about one of my favorite hobbies, board games. I love them. If you like board games, you should check out The Board and Barrel every Sunday night at 7:30 Pacific on twitch.tv/KyleMcCarlin, where me and my buddies play board games. We also give you guys a chance to help us or hurt us, depending on how you feel, with our buff and nerf house rules. And we have virtual bingo cards you can fill out while you're watching the show. It's a good time. Hope to see you there.